You're my positive and encouraging KFM, Melissa Jordan and Citizen Way, and I'm with you, and we are with you today. It is Spring Sharathon 2021 right across the KFM Radio Network. Thanks for being with us here this morning as we raise funds for Christian Radio, for KFM, for the next 6 months. We really need you today to call.
Exactly. Well, the only way that we stay here on the air is because of the generosity of you, our listeners. And so we want you to give us a call right now. The phone lines are open, 1-888-674-2585, and support Christian Radio as we reach into 13 different communities across Northern Ontario.
We are going to have a lot of fun today, and the Funmeister is here with us, Curtis.
I've been called a lot of things, John, but Funmeister? I don't know if that's one of them.
I like that one.
Oh, yeah, you would, eh? Hey, listen, we are so excited. How about that one over there? That's much better. We are so excited about Sharathon this year and the fact that people are listening this early in the morning. That is amazing. So we just want to let you know that we have a great prize we're giving away. I mean, fantastic prize. I don't know if we've shown this already. We probably have. I've just been busy with so many other things this morning. But we're giving away a shower speaker. Yeah, we're not giving away any. The shower speaker is what we're giving away this morning. And I don't know if you've ever had like a little something, like a speaker, a radio, or something in the shower. Showers go better with KFM. What can I say? It's just that good. And we're giving this away in 39 minutes. Your way to get in on this, of course, is by supporting KFM. And we would love for you to call in this morning. There it is right there. If you happen to be on our website right now, at kfmradio.ca. That's kfmradio.ca. Our amazing guru, Dan Thompson, is providing all of this on our stream for you to take part in and actually see the things we're giving away. You can also find them on Facebook. I know John's very busy on our social media today. So you can get in on this simply by calling and letting us know you're standing with us. We're giving away this great shower Bluetooth speaker. So all you do is, you know, you hit the play button on your phone, and while you're in the shower, this little speaker provides all the tunes for you. So that's just our way of saying thank you this hour. Call right now. Would you let us know that during this first hour of our Spring Sharathon, our very first hour, that, yeah, you're standing with us. Hey, thanks for the people that have...
crony Tony.
Live from our studios in Timmins, it's our crony Tony.
Tony.
Tony?
I can't believe you played that jingle.
Hey, listen, when you got your own jingle, you got to travel with it.
I don't got my own jingle.
Yeah.
It makes me laugh every time.
Well, Tony, anyway. Here we are. It is a Sharathon Day, and live across KFM Radio Network, we're checking in with you.
undeniable faith. Give me hope. Give me love unconditional, love that won't let me go. Oh, it's something greater that I can't explain. All creation's pointing to your name. It's been 2,000 years and hearts still change. It's clear to me you're here with me. God, you are undeniable, 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 indisputable, irrefutable. This is what I know in my bones. It's clear to me you're here with me. God, you are undeniable.
Undeniable here on Positive and Encouraging KFM. We are so thrilled that you are joining with us across the KFM radio network today. We've got all of 3 minutes before the top of the hour, 3 minutes to go, and we'll be wrapping this up and giving away this amazing Bluetooth shower speaker. It's one of my favorite things to give away. Love the people who've
budget for the next 6 months.
It is. God's given us this privilege to broadcast over the air all across Northern Ontario, 13 different communities. We're the western edge of KFM, and we just love being the western edge. We love seeing this whole kingdom grow here. It's so fabulous. It's just wonderful.
Well, I know, Bill, we're going to end off with your inspiring quote of the day because we just love it, but we want to encourage everyone this morning to call this number, 1-888-674-2585. We'd love to hear from the Sault Ste. Marie, Algoma District this morning. We'd love to hear from you this hour. Call now, 1-888-674-2585. Bill, give us your inspiring quote today.
Speaking of encouragement, David Jeremiah once said, "Everyone is in need of encouragement at some time. Take the opportunity today to encourage the one or ones who often encourage you." That's our inspiring quote for this Spring Sharathon Day.
Love it, Bill. Thanks for the chat this morning. We'll see you again later on today. But yes, call that number now, 1-888-674-2585.
Sometimes it's hard to believe that you're working things out for me, but I can't see. I'm walking with blindfolds on, but you're more sure than the ground that I stand on. And I know that you won't cave in. So I trust you, even when I can't see the full plan. Everything seems to make no sense. I know that you're in control. Oh, I trust you, even when I don't understand. My life is in your hands. I know that you're in control. Oh, I've been faithful all my days, so why do never forsake me, no. You know my every need before I can say a thing. Your promises, yes and amen, yes and amen. So I trust you, even when I can't see the full plan. Everything seems to make no sense. I know that you're in control. I trust you, even when I don't understand. My life is in your hands. I know that you're in control. See the full plan. Everything seems to make no sense. I know that you're in control. I trust you, even when I don't understand. My life is in your hands. I know that you're in control. Oh.
Oh, helping to change lives for over 20 years.
KFM means everything to me. KFM was there when the Lord touched me and saved me. KFM has been such a wealth of information and such a wealth of knowledge and such a wealth of teaching. And KFM also is a great conversation starter. KFM is a great ministry tool. Just tune in and you'll hear what you need to.
A positive alternative for you and the ones you love. This is Sharathon on KFM.
Nobody changes the world.
Standing in the crowd.
Nobody's voice is ever heard.
Until they open their mouth.
Won't let a loud go quiet. Won't let the saints go silent. Let's turn it up. Tell the world what we're about.
Have an Amazon Fire tablet, a 7-inch Amazon Fire tablet. That's our prize from 7 o'clock to 8 o'clock.
So we are still tabulating the calls and the PayPal donations that came in the last hour. So we'll find out who's going to win our Bluetooth speaker shortly. But yes, right now up for grabs is this fantastic Amazon Fire 7-inch computer tablet. Who doesn't want a tablet?
Oh, exactly. I love my tablet that I use, and it's a great way of just doing all those fun little things, play some games, or you can listen to KFM, all sorts of great things that you can do on your tablet.
Yeah, so we invite you to call now at 1-888-674-2585, 1-888-674-2585. It is our Spring Sharathon 2021. You can also give securely online as well.
Yeah, go to our webpage, which is kfmradio.ca, and a couple things you can do there. Number one, you can donate through PayPal safely and securely. It's a really simple process, and you can make a donation by going there. The other thing that you can do while you're there is you can watch the Sharathon unfold as it's happening, as we've got a video feed there. And so you can go to kfmradio.ca and check that out as well.
More great music throughout the morning as well. We've got Starfield coming up, but we received so much great testimony in this past year of what KFM means to you and your family. Have a listen to this.
Helping to change lives for over 20 years.
KFM means everything to me. KFM was there when the Lord touched me and saved me. KFM has been such a wealth of information and such a wealth of knowledge and such a wealth of teaching. And KFM also is a great conversation starter. KFM is a great ministry tool. Just tune in and you'll hear what you need to.
A positive alternative for you and the ones you love. This is Sharathon on KFM.
There is nothing left to Every
positive and encouraging KFM with Maverick City, man of your word. It's 7:24 on this beautiful Wednesday morning. Well, I mean, it's beautiful outside my window. You know, nowadays when, I mean, we broadcast from Mattawa all the way to Sault Ste. Marie, from Sunridge and all the way to Kapuskasing. So it's this vast chunk of Northern Ontario that we cover. So it literally can be sunny in one part of our broadcast area and a blizzard in the other. So, yeah, depending on where you are this morning, whatever's outside your window. It's Sharathon 2021. Here we are in a brand new year in our first Sharathon of 2021. And I know we have new listeners because we've seen your comments on Facebook over the last few days. And people saying, yeah, I just found your channel like last week. And it's so exciting as we have listeners from all over Northern Ontario tuning in. So let me just briefly explain what this day's all about. And you guys are talking about money today. You never talk about money. Well, that's true. We made a pledge 24 years ago to only talk about money twice a year. That's it. And that's pretty good, I think, compared to maybe a lot of other ministries. But here we are. We take an offering twice a year because we are listener-supported Christian radio. You don't hear, you know, 8 or 12 commercials every half hour selling everything under the sun. We decided a long time ago that, no, we want to be a real ministry-focused station and not have to go out and sell commercials to Pepsi and McDonald's and the rest of that. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but we just chose to have a different path so we could really be ministry-oriented radio. And that's because of your incredible support we're able to do this. So today's the day we raise the budget for the next 6 whole months. So we need a really, really big offering over today and tomorrow. That's what we need. So if you could call in, we'll put your name in the draw. This hour, we're giving away a Fire Amazon tablet. Yeah, a tablet. Everybody can use one of those nowadays because we're practically living online in so many areas of our lives. Call right now. We'll put your name in the old hat for this draw coming up at the top of the hour. And we would love for you to just walk away with this great prize. And, of course, we appreciate your support. You can call right now, 1-888-674-2585. That's 1-888-674-2585. Or you can give online at kfmradio.ca.
KFM News, here are the stories we're following. The Northern Lights Festival Boreal has canceled the traditional outdoor festival in Bell Park in Greater Sudbury once again. It was scheduled for July. It is the second consecutive cancellation due to COVID-19. The Sioux Area Hospital has been notified by the province to expect critical care patient transfers. They will be from across the province. The hospital's capacity has been expanded to support the development. Ontario Premier Doug Ford is self-isolating after a staffer he came into contact with Monday has tested positive for COVID-19. Several other staff members are doing the same, pending a COVID-19 test. In international news, Queen Elizabeth II turns 95 today. There will be no public celebrations in the aftermath of Prince Philip's funeral. And from the good news file, residents in PEI at a nursing home got quite the surprise after staff created a no-charge Tim Hortons drive-thru in their building. Residents were more than happy to participate, and even the staff jumped in, as any of us might, as you don't want to miss the fun. This is KFM News. I'm Andrew White.
Here's Dr. Charles Stanley.
You're not going to find pride in the heart of a man or woman who understands the grace of God. You're not going to find it. Because that person is always going to be pointing people to Christ, to God. It is all of God, none of us. All of Christ and none of us.
Hear the series, Grace for Today, this week on In Touch with Dr. Charles Stanley.
Keep in touch with Dr. Charles Stanley, weekday mornings at 9:30.
Brought to you by Jim's Portable Toilets and Septic Service for homes, business, and industry. For North Bay today, increasing cloudiness this morning, a high plus one. For Timmins, a chance of flurries this morning, then clearing, a high plus two. For Elliott Lake today, sun and cloud, a high plus three. For Sault Ste. Marie today, mainly sunny, a high of zero. And for Greater Sudbury, sun and cloud, a high of plus one. Right now in North Bay, it's minus 9 with a wind chill of minus 14. In Timmins, it's minus 9. In Elliott Lake, it's minus 8. In Sault Ste. Marie, it's minus 5. And in Greater Sudbury, it's minus 10 degrees with a wind chill of minus 15. This has been your KFM Satellite Weather Forecast.
positive and encouraging KFM. Sorry about that. Mandy, I was just enjoying the song so much. I love Mandisa. And good morning. And good morning to you. Thank you for tuning in to Sharathon 2021. What an exciting start to the Sharathon. And I got to let you in. I got to let you in on the behind the scenes here for a moment because pray for KFM this morning. Oh, we're having so many little technological challenges kicking off the Sharathon. We're using, you know, a new system. And, yeah, it's been a bit of a learning curve, let's say. So we actually lost some connections, but we're getting them back on now. So thank you for your patience through these first couple of hours of a Sharathon. And, yeah, we're going to be announcing the winners. We're just dealing with these issues first to get our technology back online, and then we'll be announcing some winners. But in the meantime, the phones still work, and you can call in or you can go online. This is Sharathon 2021. We're raising the budget for the next six whole months. And as you can imagine, during this year of COVID, we really need your help. You know, we don't go on the air, and I don't like the term beg. We don't do that. We just express and try to be as honest and transparent as possible about the needs. And KFM's got some pretty big needs. We are on the doorstep of getting New Liskeard on the air, which is will be our 13th station on the air. I mean, we've got the 13 licenses. All of that's great. It's just getting that antenna on the tower. We had to wait till warmer weather showed up. And thankfully, that warmer weather is now here. So we can get that installed very, very shortly. That'll be amazing. And then we are looking. We've been invited to at least three more places. And we're basically just praying, okay, God, if you supply, because, you know, it's one thing saying, oh, you know, it's wonderful. We have 13 radio stations on the air, nearly half a million people able to tune in. But when the monthly bills start coming in, it's like every month you have to pay for all those towers because we rent space on those towers. And those bills are just enormous. You know, just one bill that comes in for Sudbury is astronomical, $7,000. That's the Sudbury bill that comes in every 6 months. And that's the way they bill us, is every 6 months, because they know that's when we have a Sharathon. So, yeah, the needs are really big across Northern Ontario, and we're so thankful for you. Here's how you can support KFM today and keep us strong. Go to our website, kfmradio.ca.
Living room to the kitchen, from the office to the camp, filling your life with hope. This is Sharathon 2021 on KFM.
every hand that reaches out, every hand that reaches out to offer peace.
That song, that's one of my faves of all time. Avalon, Testify to Love. It's Sharathon 2020.
Was it the song that you dedicated as Bobby?
Yes, I have a long history with that song. It's Sharathon 2020 right across the KFM radio network. What an exciting day we have planned for you. Now, we got so excited with the music and everything. We still need to get our grand prize, our winner from last hour.
Yeah, I know.
Let me remind you about this hour's prize.
Yeah, we've got a great prize for this hour. Between 7 and 8 o'clock, we have an Amazon Fire 7-inch computer tablet. A great prize, and all you can win that by donating or right now.
That's right.
By 1-888-674-2585 or by going to our webpage, which is kfmradio.ca, and safely and securely giving through PayPal there. So great prize this hour, and we had a great prize last hour.
Absolutely. So we're going to find out shortly who won that, and we're almost done this hour's prize already. But we want to make sure that you know that we care. This has been an incredible year of change for a lot of people, and we have really tried in this past year to be a beacon of hope on the airwaves, because the airwaves has a lot of things to offer.
That's it.
And not all of it has been great. And so we're always very aware of, you know, every song we decide to play, every word we decide to utter. Is this going to be positive and encouraging? And we've heard back from so many of you over this past year of that KFM has meant that to you, that, and no matter the age, you know, there's a young 10-year-old girl who emailed us and said when she's in pain, KFM is there for her. Isn't that amazing?
That's amazing.
Just a young girl. And then at the other end of the scale, we hear from some of our more mature listeners who've said, you know, you take me through the darkest times of the night when I can't sleep. I turn KFM on, and there you are. There was a time I've been around long enough to remember when radio stations used to sign off at midnight.
We would just turn off the signal.
Play the national anthem and see you in the morning.
Yeah, exactly. And then there would just be that test signal.
That's right. But KFM is on 24/7, 7 days a week, all year long, 24 hours a day. And it's because of our amazing sponsors, our amazing supporters, that KFM has managed to still be on the air. And we really need you this time around. Here's a phone number to call to keep hope alive in Northern Ontario. John, that number?
1-888-674-2585. Give us a call, 1-888-674-2585.
Okay, we're going to get the winner of our 6 o'clock hours Bluetooth shower speaker in just a moment. But so many great testimony. I want you to have to listen to another one here this morning.
Helping to change lives for over 20 years.
I've been thinking lately about ministry and how to be an instrument in God's hands. And I listened to KFM, and that really impacted my life and let me know, like, the mission field is our neighbors. It's just everybody around us. And that really blessed and touched me immensely, because I'm registered blind, so I can't get out a lot. But now I have an opportunity and have been reaching out to my neighbors, and I thank you that your radio station had a part to play in that.
A positive alternative for you and the ones you love. This is Sharathon on KFM.
Sometimes I wonder, is he faithful? Does he see me in my trouble? Does he understand? Sometimes I question if he's able. Can he rescue? Can he save me again and again? But when I look back, did he move every mountain? Did he part every sea? Yes, he did. So yes, he can. Oh, did he defeat the darkness? Did he deliver me? Yes, he did. So yes, he can. Oh, yes, he did. So yes, he can. 'Cause sometimes those voices try to tell me I'm forgotten and I'm falling too far from his hands. But I know what kind of God he is, and I'm trusting in his promises. I'm believing and I'm singing, yes, he can. Yes, he can.
Kane, and yes, he can on KFM, one of the great up-and-coming bands of this past year.
Oh, yeah, I love Kane.
It's Sharathon 2021. All right, Curtis is here. We finally have the winner of our last hour's prize, which was a beautiful waterproof Bluetooth shower speaker. Curtis, I know many are waiting with bated breath here this morning to see who gets to take home that.
You know, our humble apologies. We have had so many technological issues over the last 2 hours. I mean, I don't even want to begin to tell you, but
no.
I think we're getting almost back on track. So, yeah, we should typically announce the winner like 5-10 minutes past the hour. Just give us time to total up all those calls. But, yeah, well, congratulations going out to Steve Marshall. Congratulations.
Steve Marshall. Oh, yeah. Steve Marshall celebrating.
Oh, yeah, there we go.
Congratulations, Steve, with that Bluetooth speaker for your shower, or bring it anywhere you want where it could possibly get wet.
That does conjure up some pictures of, just enjoying your shower. That's with the Bluetooth speaker. There you go.
Absolutely. Okay, so in just a few minutes, we'll actually have another winner. Curtis, this Amazon Fire 7-inch computer tablet.
Come on, this is amazing. We're giving away a tablet in just a few minutes, and we will announce the winner within 5 to 8 minutes or so past the hour.
Okay.
So you've got 3.5 minutes to call in right now. Let us know you're supporting KFM, standing with us, and we're going to give away an Amazon tablet in just a few minutes. So please go online, like every single gift online, by the way, gets your name automatically into the draw, just like Steve did. He gave online, and he got his name into that first draw of the day, the second one coming up in just a few minutes. So if you go online, kfmradio.ca, you can give securely right there, or you can call, and our phone team loves when the phone
station and keep KFM on the air more than ever in this time in human history. We believe it's important to be putting hope on the airwaves.
Yes, indeed, it is Sharathon 2021 for the spring of 2021, and we're glad to have you part of it this morning. If you're just joining us, we're raising the budget for the next 6 months of KFM right across Northern Ontario. So before we get into our first song, a couple of things to take care of.
Yes.
We got a brand new prize up for grabs this hour.
We do. We've got a great prize. We have G20 Anafire earbuds. Now, these are wireless earbuds.
Oh, these are popular.
Yeah. And so this is a great prize. And so all you have to do is make a donation to KFM during this hour, which puts you in a draw for our hourly prize, as well as puts you in a draw for our grand prize, which we're going to unveil a little bit. We're teasing it out.
Right.
It's going to be a great prize package. All you got to do is call us right now, 1-888-674-2585, or you can go to our webpage, kfmradio.ca.
And a real treat for the kids coming up in just a couple of minutes. Our pal Cal is going to be joining us. So stick around for that as we celebrate Christian radio across Northern Ontario. It's the KFM Spring Sharathon.
Across the sky, new mercies rise, and the future.
future's bright. Whoa, this is a new day.
Come on,
everything's bursting with hope.
Woo.
Come on alive. This moment, moment, you got a freedom.
You got a freedom.
Not looking back anymore. Open your eyes. It's coming, coming. This is a new day. The old is gone away.
Goki, new day on KFM. It's 8:09. It's our spring Sharathon. And boy, oh boy, we're very excited this morning. We're already 2 hours into it.
Yep.
We've given away a shower speaker, Bluetooth shower speaker.
Yep.
We're about to give away an Amazon tablet.
Yep.
This hour's prize.
We've got a great set of wireless earbuds. They are Anafyr G20 earbuds. And you can go to our Facebook page and check that out and see what great prize. And so if you make a donation to KFM right now by going to our webpage, kfmradio.ca, or by giving us a call at 1-888-674-2585, you get your name into a draw for this great prize.
Mark out how we say good day from Timmins. Mark out how we say, oh, how do you do?
Live from our studios in Timmins, it's our pal Cal. Good morning, Cal.
Good morning, my friends.
Oh, there's the bassy tones of our pal Cal in Timmins this morning. Cal, the day is here. Sharathon is underway. Tell us what Christian radio and KFM has meant these few. There's a lot of negativity we could concentrate on out there. It's available. It's out there. And
oh,
it's
yeah.
More important than ever to really have Christian radio come into people's homes and vehicles. Probably more than any time in history, I'd say.
You know, I truly believe that. I mean, history right now, we're living it, as we all know. And yeah, that's true words were never spoken. We need, when we turn on our radios in our car and we're heading out somewhere, people are angry, people are upset, people are frustrated, people are scared.
Mm.
But they can listen to the message of Christian radio, what we're trying to promote, the Lord and Savior is reigning. He sits on his throne, and that's the message that we're getting out to the highways and byways. There's just tremendous hope that's being offered, and KFM, we're privileged. We really do count every one of us who help out with KFM, either on the vocal side or the technical side, whatever it happens to be, even the everybody answering the phones today. We're just happy to be part of this. And this is an opportunity for our partners, of course.
Absolutely. Yeah. And so we thank you for your support. Cal, thanks for checking in with us this morning. We'll hear from you periodically throughout the day as well. Have a fantastic day, and we'll chat with you later, okay?
You bet. Take care.
There we go. There's our pal Cal with on with us here this morning. Nice to hear from Timmins, Iroquois Falls,
yes.
Many communities who are tuned in this morning. So in just a few minutes, Curtis is here. Curtis, have we got a winner yet for this Amazon tablet?
We absolutely do. I was just waiting for you to finish up with Cal. Our congratulations going out to Lana Neal.
Lana Neal!
Congratulations!
Congratulations.
Wow, what a great, great gift to be walking away with.
Man, oh man, you said it. I'd love to get a tablet before 9 o'clock in the morning. What a great prize. The prize for this hour is a G20 Anifier earbuds. These earbuds are so popular.
Yes.
And if you go to our website, kfmradio.ca, you'll be able to watch what's happening with the events here with the Sharathon, and you'll see the prize as well. And there's another place you can see the prize, John.
Yeah, we post a picture of the prize on our Facebook page. So each hour we put up the new prize, and you can just go to our Facebook page, which is KFM Radio Northern Ontario, and check it out.
And Curtis, such an important thing we're asking people to do here. We got 45 minutes left this hour, 45 minutes in the morning show. All your favorite teaching programs are coming through starting at 9 o'clock, but we don't want you to stop calling in, and we really, really need you, especially in the times that we live in now. Everyone is looking for hope, Curtis, and we are keeping hope alive thanks to our listeners.
Yeah, call right now, 1-888-674-2585. That's toll-free from anywhere in Ontario, 1-888-674-2585, or you can give securely on our website at kfmradio.ca.
Helping to change lives for over 20 years.
I'm a contractor in central Manitoulin, and I have the radio on all day long, and you guys are with me that whole time. I find it challenges me, it teaches me, it comforts me, it helps me to grow.
A positive alternative for you and the ones you love. This is Sharathon on KFM.
Maybe midnight or midday, never early, never late. He gon' stand by what he claimed, lived enough life to save.
I heard your heart, I see your pain, out in the dark, out in the rain. Feel so alone, feel so afraid. I heard you pray in Jesus' name.
It may be midnight or midday, it's never early.
Help is on the way. Sometimes it's days, sometimes it's years. Some face a lifetime of falling tears. But he's in the darkness, he's in the cold. Just like the morning, he always shows.
It may be midnight or midday, it's never early.
Show.
Newsboys, way beyond myself on KFM 822. It's our Spring Sharathon 2021. If you're just tuning in, we would love to hear from you this morning as we raise funds for the budget for the next 6 months of operations here at KFM right across the KFM radio network.
Yeah, thank you to those who have called in and supported Christian radio and, you know, have really given us that good kickoff to Sharathon Spring 2021. And every time you call in and make a donation, you get entered into two draws. One is the hourly prize, which this hour's is a great prize, as we've got a set of earbuds, G20. That's where we're at. Yeah, G20 Anifier earbuds. And you also get your name put into a grand prize draw, which is yet to be revealed.
Yes. Curtis is here. Curtis, we have not revealed our grand prize yet. Those who are part of our exclusive KFM email club will have gotten a news on that early this morning if they opened up their email. But we haven't said it on air yet what our grand prize is.
It does pay to open up your email, doesn't it?
It does.
You get to find out all the scoopy information. Hey, listen, I have a scripture to share this morning. It says in Isaiah 52:7, how beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of those that bring good tidings and publish peace. That's what the King James Version says. Do you know another word for publish is broadcast? And years ago, I mean, we've known the scripture for a very long time. And years ago, when we first started in broadcasting, I realized that there is a footprint of a radio tower, and that the feet of the tower are the anchors. And it was just so appropriate to think, you know, how lovely up on the mountain, because all these towers are on mountains that we're on today. Most of them are on a mountaintop. And it says how beautiful on the mountains are the feet of those that broadcast peace. If you kind of condense that, and it's just so amazing. So we're so thankful. There's so many scriptures that encourage us to be broadcasters of the good news, to be sharers of hope in especially a year like this, where, you know, most public meetings have been closed for the better part of a year, or at the very least limited, whereas there has been no limit to what radio can do. There's been no capacity or no ceiling in which how many people can tune into radio and hear about hope and hear about this good news and the peace of God that only God can offer. And it's all right there in Isaiah that this is what we're to do, to be on those mountains, to share the good news, and to broadcast peace to Northern Ontario. Listen, this is what we need right now. I've only got like 30 seconds to do this. We need monthly partners. Perhaps you would consider becoming part of our 1K Club. 1K Club member pays for an entire hour every single month. So you could do this by calling in. It's a gift of $83.33 a month. If you could do that right now, become a brand new 1K Club partner. We have a very special 1K Club KFM jacket to give to you. Just our way of saying thank you on behalf of our great sponsors. So call right now, become a brand new 1K Club member. Your name goes into the draw for this hour, plus you'll get a jacket if you call right now, though. So call 1-888-674-2585. Call right now, 1-888-674-2585, and we will set aside a beautiful, brand new 1K Club KFM spring jacket, just our way of saying thank you. Would you become a partner right now with Christian Ministries? And would you be that one that says, yeah, I want to be part of Isaiah 52 and be up on that mountain through KFM and publish and broadcast the good news and the message of hope and peace to this generation? Do it right now. 1-888-674-2585, Dean.
You are needed. Call now. For King and Country, God Only Knows on KFM.
Hey, this is Joel with For King & Country, and you are listening to positive and encouraging KFM.
Wide awake while the world is sound asleep, and too afraid of what might show up while you're dreaming. Nobody, nobody, nobody sees you. Nobody, nobody will believe you. And every day you try to pick up all the pieces, all the memories that somehow never leave you. Nobody, nobody, nobody sees you. Nobody, nobody will believe you.
God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows how it's killing you. But there's a kind of love that God only knows.
God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. But God only knows the real you. Cause there's a kind of love that God only knows.
There's a kind of love that there's a kind of love.
You keep a cover over every single secret, so afraid if someone saw them they would leave. Somebody, somebody, somebody sees you. Somebody, somebody will never leave you.
God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows how it's killing you. But there's a kind of love that God only knows.
God only knows.
This is KFM News. Here are the stories we're following. Health Sciences North will receive its first COVID-19 patient transfer from the GTA in the coming days. This is as hospitals in the province reach a critical point for patient care, and it's believed to be the first transfer of many to come. At least one North Bay resident has been displaced following an early morning fire. It happened in the 1100 block of O'Brien. There is no word as to the cause nor the total damage done. Sault Ste. Marie police are looking for a missing youth. 15-year-old Jeremy Rowlandson was last seen last Wednesday in the area of Trunk Road and Queensgate Boulevard. He is 5'10" tall, weighing 155 pounds, with brown hair and brown eyes. And an employee at a New Jersey diner had to learn the hard way this week after a rather un-Canadian Canada Goose got a little more than snippy in the parking lot. The employee is expected to be okay, short of a few bumps and bruises, but experts say it is nesting season, and male geese can become especially protective around the nest, and it's never a good idea to try and take a gander. This is KFM News. I'm Andrew White.
KFM Satellite Weather.
Brought to you by Jim's Portable Toilets and Septic Service for homes, business, and industry. For North Bay today, increasing cloudiness this morning, a high plus one. For Timmins, a chance of flurries this morning, then clearing, a high plus two. For Elliott Lake today, sun and cloud, a high plus three. For Sault Ste. Marie today, mainly sunny, a high of zero. And for Greater Sudbury, sun and cloud, a high of plus one. Right now in North Bay, it's minus 9 with a wind chill of minus 14. In Timmins, it's minus 9 with a wind chill of minus 14. In Elliott Lake, it's minus 8. In Sault Ste. Marie, it's minus 5. And in Greater Sudbury, it's minus 10 with a wind chill of minus 16 degrees. This has been your KFM Satellite Weather Forecast.
8:32. Thanks, Andrew. It is
true. I could use a reminder. Oh, I need something that can fill my soul. Oh, on a record on the radio. Ain't nothing like a gospel song. Makes me want to sing it all day long. Something about that amazing grace. Sound of praise makes my troubles.
Gospel song on KFM. It's 8:37. Here it is, Spring Sharathon Day for 2021. Thanks for joining us this morning. What a special day this is as we get to partner with you and you with us to raise the budget for the next 6 months for Christian Radio across Northern Ontario. And we've been hearing from many of you this morning, from Timmins to Iroquois Falls, North Bay, Sudbury, Sault Ste. Marie, well, some of the smaller communities as well. Really encouraging to hear people excited about new Liskard coming online very shortly.
Yeah, we're counting down the days until we get new Liskard on the air. And Curtis mentioned a great way in order to be able to support KFM, becoming a monthly partner.
Yes.
And if you join the 1K Club, which works out to be about $80 and something, 33 cents, a little bit more than that. And if you do that, you become a part of the 1K Club, and you get yourself a really nifty jacket.
It's a snazzy jacket.
Yeah, myself a nifty jacket.
It's really neat, and it's a great way. We've had lots of people tell us during the year, outside of Sharathon, people that are part of the 1K Club come to us and say, people ask me, how did I get one of these jackets? They're really, really nice jackets. You get to choose what kind. There's a couple to choose from.
Maybe at some point during the Sharathon, I'll model online my wonderful 1K jacket.
Did you get the fleece?
I got the fleece
You did get the fleece one. Okay. So it's that easy to become a part of the 1K Club, or a one-time donation of $1,000. Many people have been doing that today as well. But we really need to hear from you this morning. We've got about 22 minutes left to go with this hour, and the prize up for grabs, someone is going to win a G20 Anifier earbuds.
Yeah.
At 9 o'clock, we go to all your favorite teaching programs. We'll come on between each and every one of them to kind of give you an update on what's happening.
Yeah, we've got great prizes all morning as well.
Yeah, absolutely. All morning long, every hour, even during the teaching shows, we've got a different prize for each hour. So don't go anywhere. We've got a great way for you to take part in this. So if you become a part of the 1K Club at $83.33 a month, or a one-time donation of $1,000, that's your way into a beautiful, exclusive KFM jacket. Call now, 1-888-674-2585. Many this morning, John, taking part in the option of going online.
Yeah, all you have to do is go to our webpage, which is kfmradio.ca. And if you go there, you can safely and securely give to the ministry of KFM.
I found 42 Bible verses that deal with hope.
Wow.
There's probably more.
Yeah.
But 42 of them. Here's one. You are my hiding place and my shield. I hope in your word.
Amen.
And that's what KFM is about. And it's thanks to you that we can continue to be a voice of hope in this world today, and certainly in Northern Ontario. We've heard from many of you over the course of this past year of what KFM means to you and your family. Here's another one of those stories.
Helping to change lives for over 20 years.
In March 2017, I started attending church, and there was an ice storm, and I couldn't go. And my mom told me you can listen to church on KFM at 10 a.m. And the first time I ever heard of KFM, man, was that ever wonderful. What a great resource to have in my life as a brand new Christian at the time. It was just such a great guide, you know, with sermons and guest speakers and the music and books and resources that I have found along the way. KFM continues to be a guide to me living as a Christian. I trust that whatever comes from KFM is so good.
A positive alternative for you and the ones you love. This is Sharathon on KFM.
I've been empty. When I'm low, you fill the cup. Yeah, but my ego fights back, telling me that I'm ready to grab the wheel and take control. But I'll crash if I don't let myself let go. You put the X on my faded map. Draw me a line back to where you're at. Patient when I try to move too fast. I get this feeling in my spirit when I'm low. I hear it calling like a compass in my soul, saying, child, come on back now. You've been gone too long. Let me lead you back where you belong. Right next to me. Right next to me. I've been captive by the plans I try to make. Yeah, I've been selfish, 'cause callous hearts, they die hard. Like habits that I know I gotta break. Ain't it good to know that help is on the way? In my soul, saying, child, come on back now. You've been gone too long. Let me lead you back where you belong. Right next to me. Oh, oh, oh. You know I tried to do it on my own. Oh, oh, oh. You say it's time for me to come back home. Right next to me. Feeling in my spirit when I'm low. I hear it calling like a compass in my soul, saying, child, come on back now. You've been gone too long. Let me lead you back where you belong. I get this feeling in my spirit when I'm low. Right next to me.
Call now to qualify for this hour's prize. 1-888-674-2585. It's Sharathon 2021 on KFM. Thank you.
Before you heard the song, you gotta let them know the truth is alive to shine upon the way, so maybe they can go sing your praises once more. Sing your praise to the Lord. Come on, everybody, stand up and sing one more. Hallelujah, give your praise to the Lord. I can never tell you just how much good that it's gonna do you.
There's Amy Grant from 1982 and Praise, Sing Praise to the Lord. What a great song. That is, that's early Amy.
Oh, yeah, it is. And actually, I think you were we were talking off air and you said, I wonder if that's Michael W. Smith playing the piano.
On the piano.
Well, he was one of two piano players that,
okay,
that was used on that album by Amy Grant.
I just knew it. I just knew it. All right, here we are. It is a Spring Sharathon 2021. Curtis, what an amazing morning we've had so far.
Oh,
we've only got like 13 minutes left to go.
And we want to thank people from Sault Ste. Marie calling in with a $10 gift. New Liskard. Wow. Hey, New Liskard. Called in with a gift. Sudbury called in with a $50 gift. We're not going to name names because of confidentiality. But we'll tell you what city they're in. People can kind of guess. Oh, that was me. So, North Bay called in with a $500 gift. Thank you for that. North Bay also called in with a $100 gift. Sudbury, a $200 gift. And North Bay again calling in with a $30 gift. So Sudbury and North Bay doing a lot of the calling. We need to hear from everybody this morning. No matter where you live, we need you in on this. We've only got 12 minutes before the top of the hour. We're giving away a great set of earbuds this hour. I do have a pair of earbuds, one of the few technological things I have. I know how to stick them in my ear. I'm pretty good at that. And so a pair of earbuds we're giving away in about 10 minutes from now. And we would just love you. Every call qualifies before, just to let you know. Every single call qualifies for our giveaway. So let's just make that very clear. But you can call in. We need to hear from everywhere this morning. I'm going to get my little map out after the lunch hour. And I'm going to start reading off the names of... Do you know that we reach over 200 communities, Dean?
Wow.
200.
Wow.
Yeah, that's what I said. Wow.
That's pretty amazing.
We reach about 20 to 30,000 people every single week across Northern Ontario. And about one third of Northerners have tuned in to KFM in the last 6 months. This is a ministry God's using in ways we never imagined, especially during this COVID crisis where people are looking for hope. People are looking for some good news. People are looking for some positive and encouraging music. I was talking to a lady yesterday, not a regular church goer whatsoever, and mentioned she saw my little face masks we wear nowadays, and of course mine said KFM on it, and she said, "Oh, you're with that station," and she says that station. Yeah, so you can tell right away. She's not maybe not a regular listener, but she's. You know, I tune in, and every time I do, I hear positive music.
Wow.
And that was her assessment of listening to KFM. So we're just so thankful for our partners. And if you're new to KFM and wondering, what's all this talk about money going on? It's only twice a year. That's all we do this. And the rest of the year, we just stick to the program. But today, we really need your help. You know, when you only take an offering twice a year, It's got to be a really big offering. Yeah. And we need your help today. And every single gift counts. So no matter where you're listening from this morning, maybe you're listening online and you're somewhere in the world. You know, Dean, as you know, we have partners literally around the world. We even have a partner from China who supports KFM every single year. So thank you for our online listeners. We never know who God is touching and where. But our focus, of course, here in Northern Ontario is to reach the North with a message of hope. Would you consider becoming maybe a 1K Club member? Let me tell you a little bit about this, especially if you're new to KFM, or maybe you've been around for a while. Maybe you've been giving, you know, $50 or $60 a month or whatever, which is greatly appreciated. Let's not forget that. But perhaps you're in a position where you can increase it just a little bit. Do you know it costs about $2,000 a day to keep all of our stations on the air, guys? $2,000 every single day to keep all the towers operational. And let's be clear, and I don't say this enough, and, you know, God bless Jeremy Mood when he was spent so many years here on Sharathon. I'm missing him a little bit this morning, but he would always just be bewildered on the status. And I talked to some local Christian businessmen, and they too are encouraged by the status of KFM, as we are debt-free. We have been debt-free for years and years and years. We don't have a mortgage payment. We don't have a car payment. We don't have any of those kind of things. As a matter of fact, even our utilities are paid for by some of the tenants. We rent out a little bit of space in the building that we're in, and they pay our hydro, and they pay for our heating. So it's fantastic. We don't have any of those utility expenses. They're all covered. So when you give a gift, guess what it goes towards? It goes towards bringing a message of hope to people across Northern Ontario and around the world. That's what your money's doing. It's bringing a message of hope. And we're so encouraged and we're thankful God has us in a position where we are completely debt-free. We know we owe no money to anybody, except we owe them to love them. That's what we owe. That's what the Bible says. That's actually a scripture. So the 1K Club, we broke down, so $2,000 for a whole day. So what does that mean per hour? Well, if you divide 2,000 by 24 hours a day, $83.33 pays for an entire hour each month. So that's pretty incredible. That can be like your gift to the Lord is saying, okay, God, for an hour every month, I'm sharing hope with Northern Ontario. That's what I want to do. You know, some people just give the full amount in one check and say, okay, here's the $2,000. That covers me for a month, for 1 hour every month during the year. So that's what we're doing. If you could do that right now, $83.33. You become a 1K Club partner, just like John Intoff is, just like so many others are. And we have a very special 1K Club KFM jacket to give to you if you can become a 1K Club member. That's $83.33 a month. And I tell you, it's not the money, really. It's the whole idea that for an hour every month, you share hope with 500,000 people that can tune in across the North. That's what you're doing. Okay, I've talked a long time, Dean, but I just wanted to get that out there. We need some more 1K Club partners right now. We've got 5 minutes left. Your name will go in for the draw of these earbuds, plus you'll get a jacket. If you could call or go online, you can go online at kfmradio.ca, or you can call right now. We've got some amazing people waiting for your phone call. 1-888-674-2585. Call in right now. We've got a jacket for you, and we put your name in the draw for the earbuds. Dean?
We'll come in one last time just before we head into Jeff and May with the Give Me the Word broadcast at 9 o'clock to kind of set the table for 9 o'clock and what the prize is for that hour. But call now. Make your pledge. Become a monthly partner, maybe for the very first time. 1-888-674-2585.
Here's another KFM classic.
W. Smith, Picture Perfect. All right, it's 9 o'clock. We're setting up a brand new hour here of a prize for our next few minutes. We want you to call in because up for grabs, John, next is a Mastercraft tool. Oh, we love our tools.
So you can get yourself a really cool, I'm going to post a picture of it in just a second on our Facebook page. You can go to our webpage, kfmradio.ca, and you can see it there as well. But who doesn't need some more tools?
Yeah, we love tools. Curtis, we've just got a couple of seconds here before we have Jeff and May come in with the Give Me the Word broadcast and some great teaching programs. We're going to keep them going throughout the morning, but we'll come in after each and every one to kind of give everyone an update, right?
We'll give you update just around 9:30. We'll bring everybody up to date.
And we'll let you know who won the these beautiful Anifier earbuds as well. It's Sharathon 2021. Give securely online at kfmradio.ca or call now 1-888-674-2585.
CJTK is a radio ministry registered as a charitable organization with Revenue Canada. We broadcast on 13 radio stations from our studios located in North Bay at 103.5, Sault Ste. Marie at 106.5, Elliott Lake at 102.5, Timmins at 105.5, and Sudbury at 95.5. We are KFM.
Give me the word, make it plain and clear to me. Give me the word, it's a light.
Give me the word, an outreach of Restoration Church. Visit us online at restorechurch.ca. Now, let's join Pastors Jeff and May Edwards as they bring us a word of encouragement, hope, and restoration for today.
Well, good morning, God bless. This is Jeff.
And May.
We're so excited to bring you today a further journey of how to fight fear and live by faith. You know, we were looking at it yesterday. We got a hold and rid of all the itites, and I gave you a disclaimer at the beginning that listening to this program could be beneficial to your health, to your wealth, to your relationships, to restoration in your life. And you know, May, as we've been talking about how to deal with fear, to live fearlessly and courageously before the Lord, I want to start off with a couple of scriptures here, and I'd just like you to give them to us so that we can go ahead and recognize that God is with us. And I want you to know how important you as an individual are to God. And I think it's so important that we remember that you're so important to God as an individual.
Some scriptures that are so encouraging. Psalm 46:10. Fear not. Practice being quiet before God. Learn to be still in his presence. Fear not. Jesus taught us not to fear people, but the God who cares for little sparrows. Luke 12:4-7. I tell you, my friends, do not be afraid of those who kill the body and after that can do no more. But I will show you whom you should fear. Fear him who, after the killing of the body, has the power to throw you into hell. Yes, I tell you, fear him. Are not five sparrows sold for 2 pennies? Yet not one of them is forgotten by God. Indeed, the very hairs of your head are numbered. Don't be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows.
You know, your value to God is absolutely incredible. I want you to recognize how much he loves you, that he's got a good plan for your life. And then as we learn to access everything that God has made available to us by faith, we've seen yesterday that we get this fear-fighting faith from Romans 10:17, where God tells us in the Word.
The Word says, consequently, faith comes from hearing the message, and the message is heard through the Word of Christ.
You know, as we look at that, we see that faith is fixed on God. And faith will make our fears flee. David said this in Psalm 56:11. In God I trust. I will not be afraid. What can man do to me? In spite of David's fears, he declared
that he would trust in God and not be afraid of man. When we think about it, most of our fears seem to originate from distrusting people. We worry about what people think about us. We can distrust people's motives and fear their agendas. However, true faith begins when we receive Christ as our Savior and we put our trust in him. Romans 5:1 says, therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ.
It's through faith that we are justified. I love Romans chapter 5, May. It's one of the most exciting chapters in the Bible, because it says 5 times in Romans chapter 5 that much more, God declares much more if we've been justified, that there's much more grace to those that will just step out in what God has for them. This faith that we're talking about is a faith that can receive from God, a faith that is exercised. I remember one of my teachers many years ago, he said it this way. He said, it's not that you don't have faith, it's just you haven't released it yet.
Mm.
I want us to release our faith today. I want us to use our faith like an arrow and point it at something to get the victory in our life. God wants to see you set free from fear. God wants to meet your needs. But God does require faith that we believe. As we said yesterday in Jairus, we talked about in Mark chapter 5, we went through the record just briefly. And once again, if you're just joining us today, thank you so much for being part of our on-air faith community, our church on the air. We like to consider you as part of our family, and we'd like to invite you just to connect with us on an ongoing basis because we love you.
We do. We're here for you. We know that we're living in difficult times. There are different challenges right now, which can open the door to worry and to fear. And that's why we're focusing on the strategies, the things that we can do to dissipate that worry and fear and live in that peace that surpasses human understanding. That's God's promise to us. So if you have a need, if we can agree with you in prayer, you can call 705-805-6401. That again is 705-805-6441. We'll agree with you in prayer with what God has to say of any situation that you're facing.
You know, when Jairus, yesterday in Mark chapter 5, we saw that Jairus was on a journey. He came and spoke to Jesus and said, "Would you come heal my daughter? She's sick and she's near unto death." And Jesus started heading that way to bring healing. And then the woman with the issue of blood in that same record in Mark chapter 5, there was a divine interruption as Jesus was going to bring a miracle, Jairus's daughter. There was another miracle that took place, and that was the woman with the issue of blood who had spent all that she had and nonetheless didn't grow any better, but the Bible says she grew worse. And she said in herself, she had said within herself, "If I but can touch the hem of his garment." So what happened? She'd heard about Jesus. She'd heard about the miracles that were performed, and that she knew within herself. She made a statement, "If I could but touch the hem of his garment." Reaching out with your faith today. If you could just say, "I'm reaching out with my faith today to touch Jesus." He's on this journey together with us. He's in the boat with us. He'll never leave us. He'll never forsake us. And you can receive your healing today if you'll fear not and only trust God. That's what's so important.
Mm-hmm. In Psalm 112, verse 1 and 7 and 8, it says, "Praise the Lord. Blessed is the man who fears the Lord, who finds great delight in his commands. He will have no fear of bad news. His heart is steadfast, trusting in the Lord. His heart is secure. He will have no fear. In the end, he will look on triumph on his foes." And also in 2 Timothy 1:7, "For God did not give us a spirit of timidity, but a spirit of power and love and self-discipline."
This is Give Me the Word, so don't be surprised that we give you lots of scripture, because the Word of God changes everything. The Word of God builds hope and faith and expectancy. And I'm hoping you yourself are beginning to understand that you can live a different life than you've ever lived before. You can live a life free from the fear and the concerns and the worries. You can have peace in the midst of a storm. That this Jesus that we talk about is real. This faith that we're talking about is a faith that works. Because when Jesus was ministering right there to Jairus, and the woman with the issue of blood, while Jesus was on that journey, received her healing, they came and spoke to the father, Jairus, and they said to him, "Don't bother the master any further, for your daughter is dead." And Jesus said to him, this is what he said, "Now don't be afraid, just go on believing." I want to say to you today, it may have taken great faith for you to tune in this morning to be part. It may have taken great faith for you to get to the point right now to where you're reaching out for help, that you're crying out to God. It took great faith. I want to encourage you, keep on believing. Keep on believing for your miracle. Keep on believing for your healing. Keep on believing for your restoration. Keep on believing. Steadfastness is crucial. And see, our faith is still required for God to work in us. It doesn't have to be big. Luke chapter 17, verse 6, may it says, if it's like a mustard seed. I've looked at mustard seeds in the grocery store. Those are little itty-bitty seeds. I think sometimes we get under the expectation that we've got to have this huge faith that everybody recognizes, and we got to be this great man or woman of impossible achievements for God to move in our life, when really God's just saying to you and me, we just need to have faith and trust him right where we're at.
Mm-hmm. We need to remember that God is bigger than our fears, our difficulties, our needs, the things that we struggle with. He's much bigger. We can overcome those fears when we trust in him. We hear his word, and we're asking him to fill us with his spirit. I want to ask you a question. Is this a fearful time for you? We're told that love casts out fear. As we walk in the love of God, fear will be driven out. Listen to 1 John 4, verse 18. There is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. We need to respond in faith to God's love, to be able to be set free from bondage, from fear, whatever is pressing in our lives.
This is so prevalent right now, and in the focus of so much prayer for our Give Me the Word team, and even for Pastor May and myself and our entire prayer team that's part of the church, because God has great things in store. And it's on the other side of the fear that your victory lies. It's, as we've said before, doing it afraid. The word of God mixed with our faith and our works accomplishes something in our lives. And I want to applaud you today. I really, really think you don't get a hold of how, as we said to begin with, how really valuable and awesome and incredible you are, and how much faith you already have. Matter of fact, the Bible tells us, if we're born again, that the same faith, the same power that raised Jesus from the dead lives on the inside of you and me. And so I applaud you today, because you're doing just what Psalm 34, 4 says. It says, I sought the Lord and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears. You know, these next few days, we're going to look at how, you know, fear can just dissipate in our lives. And then we can move into a new realm of peace, a new realm of confidence in God. And you can have that. And it happens gradually. Remember, this is a journey. Don't be so hard on yourself. You know, thank God that we've got Christian radio, and today is Sharathon Day, a day we get to celebrate, connect together, and support Christian radio. And we encourage you, please do that today as partners and friends with Give Me the Word. We're partners with KFM. Pastor May and I, we're both partners. We're part of the 1K Club that we give every month. Both of us are part of the 1K Club, to where we give every month $83.33, you know, as a personal donation to help the ongoing ministry of KFM. So I want to encourage you, perhaps you've never been a monthly partner. Perhaps you've never sown a seed, an offering into KFM to help them reach out and touch lives. And remember, we're dissipating fear everywhere this single goes, this radio single goes, that fear is being evaporated. Faith is coming alive. So today, as part of Sharathon, would you call in? Would you make your pledge? Would you give your donation? No matter how large or how small, we encourage you to do that. There's some that can give large amounts. There's some that can give smaller amounts, but each amount is so important. The pennies are just as important as the dollars, because as we all do our part, and this is what is so important, May, is everybody has a part to play for getting the gospel message out to the ends of the earth. That means you and I have both a privilege and a responsibility. It says to give into good ground. And the one thing about KFM, I will guarantee you that it's good ground. It's productive ground. The heartbeat behind the ministry is bringing people to Jesus, hope and encouragement. And you yourself are a beneficiary of that today. So as we're talking about faith and about dissipating fear in our lives, be part of that as a seed of faith for your own breakthrough, your own victory, your own fearless living. Perhaps you'd sow a seed, a financial seed, to help the KFM network not only be strong, but continue to grow and expand. It's a joy and a privilege to be able to bring you the Word of God every day, and that wouldn't be possible if it wasn't for a great network like KFM. And so as we move into the arenas of seeing fear evaporate, I like that word, May, that we're just going to, over the next few days, fear is just going to evaporate and leave our lives.
My question is, do you want more peace in your life? I know I do. Do you want more peace in your life? And we're going to discuss ways to dissipate worry. Because worry is, it's kind of like, I think of a hamster on a wheel who keeps running in a circle and he works really hard, but he's not really getting anywhere. He's getting a bit of exercise, but he's not really getting anywhere. And that's what worry does. It can encircle and circle and circle in our mind, but there's no fruit, there's no profit, there's no benefit. I want to ask you another question. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being low and 10 being high, what's your level of peace today? I'd like to share with you that as a child of God, your level of peace should be a solid 10 out of 10. Does that sound kind of far-fetched in this world today? Well, the truth is you've been given peace that passes understanding. We can find that in Philippians 4:7. Even when things look out of control, you can be in peace. However, it's up to you to make the decision to live in peace no matter what, and it won't come automatically. Like anything else in the spirit realm, you're going to have to contend for it. Philippians 4:7 says, "And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus." Another version of Philippians 4:7 says, "And the peace of God, which surpasses all comprehension, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ." Wow, if we just become mindful of that, if we just put that before us and we chew on it, we meditate on it, the peace comes, the worry goes. I think that God's word, it is the key. It's so powerful to help us have victorious lives, peaceful lives, no matter what we're going through. But peace is something that everyone desires, I'm sure, but not everyone has it. That's because true peace can only come from your relationship with God. And that's why Jesus came.
Well, Jesus came so that you and I might see the works of the enemy destroyed in our life. And the first thing that happened in the life of humanity is when Adam and Eve were deceived and Adam disobeyed God, fear came. He hid himself. Adam said, "I hid myself because I was afraid and I was ashamed." Well, fear and shame is a thing that just steals our life from us. Faith in Jesus Christ connects us. See, faith connects us to the promises of God, which have already been provided for us. Faith is where each and every victory in our life come from. It says in 1 John 5:4, that faith gives us the victory and allows us to overcome the natural world systems of sin, sickness, disease, poverty, stress, fear, and worry. One translation you were talking about there said, "Let peace be the umpire." Mm. You know, the one that just guards and protects our life. And peace is something that you can have in your life. And some great strategies. Remember, this is all birthed out of strategies. So if you get one strategy every single day from this program that we're with you at 9 o'clock every morning here, Monday through Friday. And once again, thank you. If this is the first day you've ever joined us, I'm Pastor Jeff.
And May, welcome.
And we love you so much. But get your pen ready for a very powerful series of strategies over the next few days. That's weapons of our warfare and ways to be able to keep peace and guard the peace in your life so that you don't worry like everybody else.
What's the main offender robbing believers of living in God's perfect peace? You guessed it, it's worry. Now, contrary to popular opinion, worry isn't normal. and it isn't something you should tolerate, not even for a split second. The truth is, we can all use a refresher on how to defend our peace from the one who comes to steal it. If you want more peace in your life, then let's focus on the strategies that help to dissipate that in our lives.
You know, when we look at fear and we look at what has to be dissipated in our life, then we're going to see that worry will just dissipate in our life as we learn this one incredible truth, and that is to pray in the Spirit. You know, to pray in the Spirit is an incredible gift that God gives us as part of our package of being born again. The Bible tells us that when we're born again, we see the promise of the Father. And that promise contained within it, the Holy Spirit, is tongues with interpretation, prophecy, word of knowledge, word of wisdom, discerning of spirits, faith, miracles, and gifts of healing. Now, we, Pastor May and I, we fully believe that God gives you a whole new prayer language. You know, that God will fill your tongue and your mouth with wonderful prayer language that is between you and Him as you get baptized in the Holy Ghost. Also, if you'd like to know more about what praying in the Spirit is, perhaps your particular religious denomination doesn't practice praying in the Holy Spirit or praying in other tongues, or you're not aware of it, you've never heard of it before. Well, we'd like to get you some information, because this is an incredible strategy that has worked for me in my life, because when fear tries to come on me, I just begin doing two things. I begin quoting the Word of God with my understanding, and I begin praying in other tongues. So those two powerful truths will help you incredibly. And one of the ways to do that is to just see worry evaporate out of your life as you begin to pray in the Spirit.
And Corinthians 14:4 says, a person who speaks in tongues is strengthened personally. Sometimes worry comes, it's like a sneak attack. I don't know about you, but a thought can be dropped in your head out of nowhere and start to steal your peace. You could start off with a fine day, but after an email, a text, a phone call, or a random thought, suddenly you can find yourself getting worried, upset, stressed, and not just sure how your life is going to turn out that day. I want to also add, if you were raised in an atmosphere of constant fear, this may be so ingrained in you that you will need to ask God's help to bulldoze that habit of worry right out of your life, because it becomes a habit that seems natural, even though it is not natural. When troublesome thoughts come knocking at your door, you want to dissipate worry by praying. All different forms of prayer. And then the magnitude of the situation that feels so real, very troubling, it can be difficult to know at that moment how to shift gears. That's where praying in the Spirit, praying out of your mind, praying out of your need, that's what helps.
You know, prayer, there's many different kinds of prayer. And the strategies for getting the victory in the spiritual world is learning how to fight a spiritual battle. And so there's the prayer of faith, there's the prayer of intercession, there's the prayer of agreement, and then there's what the Bible calls praying in the Spirit. The Apostle Paul said that whether I pray with my own understanding, or I pray in my heavenly language, or in the gift that was given of the Holy Spirit, that guess what happens? It's powerful prayer. Had some wonderful friends. Well, I have some wonderful friends that this praying in the Spirit was totally new to them. They were used to praying the Word of God, used to praying the prayer of faith, used to praying in agreement, but they weren't quite sure about this realm of praying in the Spirit. And I just said it to them this way. Well, if it was more of God, wouldn't you just want more of God? As you study church history and you look out all throughout church history, you'll see all kinds of denominational men and women prayed in the Holy Spirit and give reference to praying in an unknown language. Well, we want to encourage you today. Maybe you've only ever used the prayer of agreement. Maybe you've only ever used the prayer of faith, or the prayer of intercession. Well, there is a praying in the Spirit that is available to you if you're born again, that is a spiritual force that produces incredible breakthrough. Because it says when you pray in the Spirit that you're not sure what you're praying, but it's between you and God, and the enemy can't get involved in that. And so we'd like to encourage you that if you'd like more information, this is one strategy. Understand, this is just one strategy we're going to be looking at. And that one strategy is praying with your understanding and praying in the Spirit. If you'd like to know more about that, Pastor May is going to give you the number, and you can text us, you can call us. We'll get you the information, and we'll take you on a journey of an incredible little booklet that says, Why Tongues? Why Tongues? And why is praying in the Spirit such a powerful addition to our arsenal of spiritual strategies that helps us get the victory in our life? Here's the number.
705-805-6441. Once again, 705-805-6441. So every time you feel that you're starting to worry, immediately switch over to prayer or to pray in tongues. Praying in the Spirit, it packs a powerful punch in any situation. And it's a very powerful way to take every thought captive. We can find that scripture in 2 Corinthians 10:5. The prayer, it's your safeguard from worry. And interestingly, the devil can't compete with the power of the Holy Ghost. And we certainly know that.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
In Isaiah 26:3, it says, if you will keep in perfect peace all those thoughts that are fixed on you.
Yeah, it's hard for me to be quiet sometimes.
Okay.
You know, I don't know about you, but I get so excited when we start talking about strategies and ways to get the victory and how to help. And there's an anointing that destroys the yokes and removes the burdens in our life. So the strategy we want you to get a hold of today is the strategy of prayer. Prayer with your understanding, or using the Word of God, and also of praying in the Spirit out of a heavenly language, a gifting of the Holy Spirit that is available to every single one that wants it. None get left out. Everybody gets it. I've found that when fear tries to assail me, I just begin praying in the Spirit. I find that when fear tries to assail me, I just take control of my mind and I start quoting the Word of God, and I start declaring, no weapon formed against me will prosper. We recognize that these scriptures are so, so powerful. So we're going to leave you with an incredible scripture that we'll pick up here tomorrow. And here it is.
It's from Lamentations 3, verses 57. You came near when I called you, and you said, do not fear.
Well, I say to you right now, do not fear. He is with you. He'll never leave you. He'll never forsake you. Pastor May and I are joining hands right now. We're coming against the spirit of fear that would try and assault your mind. We're saying in the name of Jesus, thou foul spirit of fear, be gone in Jesus' name. We're saying to the storms of your life, peace, be still. We're speaking that the divine counsel of the Holy Spirit would come to you right now and give you divine wisdom and insight into how to pray and what prayer to use to get the victory. By your faith, you get the victory. We're praying and believing God with you that you know you are never alone by yourself. And so don't forget, Pastor May and I will be here with you tomorrow. Be generous with Sharathon this year. Give exuberantly, give joyously, and tell them this: you really like to listen to that Give Me the Word program, okay? And this is Pastor Jeff and May saying we love you, and remember this:
Jesus is risen. Victory is assured.
Give me the word.
Thank you for tuning into Give Me the Word. For more faith-building messages and resources, visit us online at restoredchurch.ca and download our app today. Remember, Jesus is risen. Victory is assured.
It's 9:30. It's our spring Sharathon. All right, we've got about a minute and a half here, Curtis, to take care of a little bit of business. We've got to give a prize away and remind you what this hour's prize is as we take your phone calls today for Sharathon 2021.
We thought it would be interesting, Dean, to let people actually hear the process. You know, how do you guys pick a winner every hour? Well, Okay. My little computer just stopped working as soon as I said that.
Oh, no.
Here, talk amongst yourselves for a minute. Let me get this going.
All right. So sometimes this is the process. There's so many elements to putting together a Sharathon. And you're hearing all of it, by the way, live on the air with us today as we celebrate the Christian Radio across Northern Ontario. Before we get into Charles Stanley, let me remind you of this hour's prize, up for grabs, Mastercraft Tool Set. So you have until 10 o'clock to call in for this. Everyone who calls in, by the way, gets their name into the draw. And here's the phone number, 1-888-674-2585. You can call anytime. You can also give securely on our website to Curtis, which is kfmradio.ca. All right, and so we are getting together the prize here. Now, the last hour's prize is a fantastic one. These earbuds are up for grabs, and we do have a system that we use. And
here we go.
Okay.
Okay, there you go. We asked Google to randomly pick a number between all these people, and 37, that is, the caller number 37 was Amy Sauter. Congratulations.
Amy Sauter, congratulations, Amy.
Sorry that took so long.
Hey, listen, it's all part of the process.
I wanted Miss Google to talk out loud, but thank you.
Well, there we go. And that's how we pick the winners. We use a randomly selected number. Okay, Charles Stanley is coming up. And as we head into Charles Stanley, call now with your pledge, with your donation at 1-888-674-2585.
He says the right attitude here is to be a cheerful giver. Because you see, grace doesn't just involve my receiving from God. Grace also involves my giving for God. It's two ways. That's the way God operates. That's the way God intends for people's needs to be met. Sowing, reaping, joyfully, cheerfully, giving. And what happens? God in turn blesses us. But ask yourself the question, how do you see your giving? And how do you see God operating in your life?
Money is extremely important, so it makes sense that God has some things to say about how we're to use it. Today on In Touch, the teaching ministry of Dr. Charles Stanley, we'll see that God will use our finances to get our attention and develop spiritual maturity. Take a fresh look at the place money has in your life as Scripture teaches us about the grace of God and our finances.
According to the Scriptures, what strong desire which motivates millions of people every day, if attained, will bring about the following consequences. It will tempt people to fall into sin. They will be tempted to fall into a trap. They will probably be mastered by some foolish desires. They will engage in harmful desires that will eat away at their character. It could plunge them into moral ruin. It could ultimately destroy them. It would cause them to wander from their faith. And it could cause many griefs to pierce their soul. What kind of desire would cause all of that to happen? In fact, it's the desire that motivates millions of people. You know what it is? The desire to get rich. The desire to get rich. 1 Timothy chapter 6. Verses 9 and 10 list all of those things which he says are dangers for those whose desire in life is to get rich. Now, there's nothing wrong with being wealthy, because there's some very, very godly people who are wealthy, very, very generous people who are wealthy. And there's nothing in the Bible that says that God takes great pleasure in poverty or keeping people poor. The problem is the issue of balance, and that is, it's one thing to be wealthy and trust God,
It's something else to be wealthy and the wealth be your God. So we're talking about the fact that when wealth is out of control, when it is out of sync with God's word and his way, then there are going to be problems. And so what we're saying in this passage is simply this, that here are eight dangers for those whose driving desire in life is to get rich. Well, what does all this have to do with the grace of God? Well, the Bible says we're saved by grace, we're to live by grace. In fact, if that's true, then there's not a single area of our life in which grace is not to have an overwhelming effect. And that is true in our finances as well as in every single area of our life. So the title of this message is The Grace of God in Our Finances. And I want you to turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 8. And in this chapter, there are two chapters here that Paul spends almost the entire chapters dealing with this matter of giving to the poor who were in Jerusalem, there in Judea, who were undergoing difficulty and hardship. And in this passage of Scripture in 2 Corinthians, he lays out some principles for us, but he also explains to us what it means to be graced by God in our giving. Listen, beginning in verse 6. Now, this I say, he who sows sparingly shall also reap sparingly, and he who sows bountifully shall also reap bountifully. Let each one do just as he's purposed in his heart, not grudgingly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound to you, that always having all sufficiency in everything, you may have an abundance for every good deed. As it is written in the Psalms, he scattered abroad, he gave to the poor, his righteousness abides forever. Now he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for the food will supply and multiply your seed for sowing and increase the harvest of your righteousness. You will be enriched in everything for all liberality, which through us is producing thanksgiving to God. Now, one thing that's very evident in this passage here is this, that it is God's desire to bless, to grace his children financially. Look at these verses. First of all, he gives us the pattern in verse 6 about sowing and reaping. Secondly, he says he loves a cheerful giver. Well, how are we going to give? In order to give, we have to have something to give. Who gives us what we have to give? God gives us what we have to give. So if God wants me to be a cheerful giver, God must provide something for me to give. So he's certainly for that, and he desires to do that. He says in verse 8 that he's able to make all grace abound to us, always, all sufficiency, everything for an abundance for every good deed. So not only here, but go back, if you will, to Proverbs chapter 3 for a moment. In the Proverbs chapter 3, notice what he says here. And if a farmer back in those days were to read this, I mean, he'd be jumping up and down with joy. But what is true of farmers is true in every single occupation, in every work. Listen to what he says in Proverbs 3, verse 9. Honor the Lord from your wealth and from the first of all your produce. You say, but I'm not wealthy. Well, wealth is whatever you have. So when we talk about wealth, we're just talking about whatever God has given us. He says, honor the Lord from your wealth, from the first of all your produce, so your barns will be filled with plenty and your vats will overflow with new wine, which is his way of saying God desires to grace his children, to grace those who are willing to abide by his principles. And so what he's saying in this passage is, first of all, God desires to do it. Secondly, he's able. Look at what he says. He says in this particular passage in verse 8, God is able to make what? Listen to this now. He's able to make all grace, that means all favor, no limitations on the favor of God. God is able to make all grace, look at this, abound. That means just overflowing, abound to you. Then look at these words, always, not sometimes, having all sufficiency, not a little bit, in everything, not some things. You may have an abundance, not some, an abundance for every good deed. God in his omnipotence can take your financial situation, no matter what it is. And if you will abide by his principle, God will grace, favor you financially. He says he's able to make what? All grace abound toward us financially. Now, when we put his principle to work, which we're going to talk about in just a moment, we put it to work, he says several things are going to happen. Verse 8, he says we're going to have sufficiency. We're going to have enough. He says, not only that, you're going to have enough to give away. That's what he means when he says in this particular verse, you may have an abundance for every good deed. That is the good deeds of giving and helping people in need. You're going to have enough to give away. He says, not only that, he says, all the other areas of your life are going to be enriched. Look at this, if you will, in verse 11. You will be enriched in everything for all your liberality. He says, God isn't going to limit his blessing just to financial blessings. He's going to also enrich you in other ways. He desires, he's able. He says, and when you abide by the principle, here's what I'm going to do. Now, what's man's part? Well, man's part's very simple. And what he says here is that two parts to man's part, man's actions and man's attitude. Now, what is man's action here? Well, let's look, if you will, at this sixth verse. Now, this I say, he who sows sparingly shall reap sparingly. He who sows bountifully shall also reap bountifully. Now, listen to me carefully. I don't know how God could have made this any simpler. If you want to reap bountifully, you've got to sow the same way. And so the whole idea of sowing and reaping is man's part. You see, God says, now here's my part. God says, I want to grace you financially. I'm able to do it. And if you'll allow me, here's what I'll do. But if you don't allow me, I can't. Now listen very carefully to this. Here is the big problem. People do not understand. If you think that you're going to be able to give God stingily, drop a dollar to an offering plate somewhere once a week, or give only when you come to church, or never give to anybody, never help anybody. If you think you're going to be able to do that, and you're going to get on your knees and you say, now, Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, I just want to ask you to bless me financially. God, you know I have needs in my family, and I have needs here and there. I'm here to tell you, you're wasting your time. Now, let me tell you why you're wasting your time. Because what you're asking God to do is to do something he can't do. You say, well, God can do everything. No, he can't. God can't violate his own nature. He can't violate his own principles. Now, look at this. If I give sparingly, chintzily, and then I ask God to bless me bountifully, I'm asking God to violate his own principle. Now, if he violated his principle by blessing me bountifully with my stingy giving, then he's not adhering to his own principles. And if he doesn't adhere to this principle, how do I know that he's going to adhere to another one I need? God can't violate his own principle. And the reason people get in financial problems and the reason they don't have enough is because they violate the principle. Then they want to cry out to God, oh, God, I want you to bless me financially. And God is saying, hey, I want to, I'd like to, I'm able to, I can't. Why can't you, God? Because you violate my principle. Well, do it anyway. I can't do that. I can't violate my own principles. So God cannot violate his principle. He couldn't have made it any simpler. The problem is their unbelief. Now listen to what he says. He says, let each one do just as he's purposed in his heart, not grudgingly or under compulsion, for God loves cheerful givers. If he loves cheerful givers, he's just itching to grace those givers. What we have to get over is unbelief. Or of thinking, well, is this going to apply to my particular circumstance? So, man's part is to practice the principle, but secondly, man's part is to have the right attitude. And what's the right attitude? He says the right attitude here is to be a cheerful giver. Because you see, grace doesn't just involve my receiving from God. Grace also involves my giving for God. It's two ways. That's the way God operates. That's the way God intends for people's needs to be met. That to be met. Listen, how many of you have ever received anything in a package that came straight from heaven? Anybody? No. You may have received many things. They all came through somebody. God blessed you through somebody. It may have been a job, or it may have been something financially or some gift, but it came through somebody. And what he's saying is, this is the way God operates. He operates through somebody. And so he says, sowing, reaping, joyfully, cheerfully, giving, and what happens? God in turn blesses us. But ask yourself the question, how do you see your giving? And how do you see God operating in your life? All right, now look at this. First of all, God's plan is that he would grace us financially. It's his desire to do it. He's able to do it. Man's part, practice the principle, and have the right attitude. That is one who is a cheerful giver. Now, that's the first part. But secondly, what is God's purpose in gracing us financially. That is, what does God really have in mind when he financially blesses someone? What does he have in mind? Well, it certainly isn't simply to make us prosperous. But two things are going to happen, he says in this passage, when you and I begin to practice the principle and allow God to grace us financially. He says, first of all, he said, our needs are going to be met. That's what he says here in this verse. He said, having all grace abound to you, that always having all sufficiency in everything. First thing that's going to happen is that our needs are going to be met. Now listen, if your needs aren't being met, I ask you a question. Are you practicing the principle of sowing and reaping? Are you giving and trusting God to multiply that? Now here's the problem. I want you to have to watch this. Here's the way most people operate. They say, God, here's my reservoir. Oh, Heavenly Father, you know I have needs. And so they pray for God to fill their reservoir before the bills come in. Under pressure, living like this. Here's my reservoir, God. I want you to bless it. And sometimes you look at that and it's about an inch deep and about a foot wide and you think, God, I don't have all my needs. You know what God's trying to get us to do? And you have to watch this. What God wants us to do is to take this reservoir and change it. He wants us to turn it up like a channel. So a reservoir may be an inch deep. A channel can be 1,000 miles long. What God wants to do, he wants to grace our finances. But listen, as long as I have the reservoir attitude, God, this is for me, and I need to be prosperous, and I need to build up my security, and Lord, you know how much I need, and God, my needs, me, myself, and I, and my family, and all the things that I want to do, and my goals, and my purposes in life. You know what God's waiting for? He's waiting for you to turn that little reservoir about an inch deep into something big enough for him to run a whole load through. And as long as I see it as mine, I limit what God's going to do. You see, he says in all of those verses, what did he talk about? He talked about us being a channel. He talked about us giving. He talked about other people being blessed through us, other people being ministered through us. And that is, we turn our reservoir into a channel through which God can bless other people. Now, he says he loves cheerful givers. Why? Because that's what he is. God is a cheerful giver. Everything you and I have came from him. And listen, we don't have what we have because we deserve it. We have what we have by the grace of God. And he doesn't give us anything to reservoir. He gives us everything to channel. Your understanding, your knowledge of the Word of God, the experiences that God has given you in your life, all the rich things that God has poured into your life. Listen, if it's there, it's going to get stagnant. You know what happens after a while? It gets so molded, it's so slimy, nobody wants it. God wants you to turn everything into a channel so that he can bless other people. It's a choice we make. Listen, there is absolutely no excuse for anyone hearing the principle and knowing that it comes from God's Word. If you don't apply it, you cannot complain to God. It is simply a principle we live by in every other area of our life. And I want to say this again. He can't violate his own principle. And his principle is not reservoir, but channel. Look at these verses. He says, God loves a cheerful giver, having abundance for every good need. He scattered abroad. He gave to the poor. Multiply your seed for sowing. Enrich you in everything for your generosity, for your liberality. You see, the key word there is generosity. Now, how am I going to know when I am really giving in the spirit of grace and it's grace giving? Well, if you took the 8th chapter of this same book, 2 Corinthians chapter 8, if you took the 8th chapter and you outlined it, this is what you would find. So I want to give you 5 statements here that really is an outline of chapter 8, but it's all about, listen, it's all about how you can know when you are really giving grace giving. That is, I mean, this is just a favor of God. This is just a spirit of generosity. Listen to this. Number one, we're going to give in spite of our circumstances. That's the first sign that it's grace giving. I'm not checking to see how much I have and how much I'm going to have left and be sure that I'm going to be able to do all the things I want to do, but Lord, in spite of my circumstances, I'm going to give. That's when the grace of God really begins to work in a person's heart financially, and the flow begins. I give, first of all, in spite of my circumstances. Secondly, I'm going to give enthusiastically. I'm going to be excited about it. He says God loves a cheerful giver. We're talking about being excited about something. And you think about, here's somebody in need or the work of the ministry or something, and you have the privilege of being a part of that. He says, not grudgingly, not under compulsion, but he said, cheerfully, joyfully, enthusiastically. Now, here's the reason that I can get enthusiastic about giving to God. Here's the reason. Not for what I'm going to see accomplished, but you know the thing that so motivates me personally and stirs my own heart? And the thing that makes me, even those times when I think, now, Lord, can I give so-and-so? Just trust me. Here's the thing that makes it exciting to me. The thing that makes it exciting to me is I'm going to find out what God's going to do. All right? Enthusiastically. Thirdly, to give as Jesus gave. To give as Jesus gave, sacrificially. And that's how I'll know when I'm giving with grace giving. I'm going to give in spite of my circumstances. I'm going to give enthusiastically, and I'm going to be willing to give sacrificially. And the fourth thing is I'm going to give it willingly, generously, cheerfully. I want to do it. And fifthly, I'm going to do it by faith. God, I can't see my way clear at this, but I'm going to do it anyway because that's what you said do. My friend, there are no exceptions. You just have to decide, do I want God to grace my finances or do I not? It's just that simple. Now, I just simply ask you a question. You want God's best? You want God to grace you financially? You want to be debt-free? You want the best God has to offer? You want to be a blessing to lots of folks? You want to be a channel, and you'll never be able to measure how far that channel goes? You want to bring glory to God and exalt the Son of God? You want to be more like Jesus? You want to have more enthusiasm and excitement in your life? You want to have more joy in your life, more cheerfulness? You want to enjoy, listen, you enjoy the spirit of generosity. That's something you enjoy. Well, friend, all of that is yours for one decision. Lord God, by faith, I will.
Thanks for joining us on In Touch, the teaching ministry of Dr. Charles Stanley. To maintain the proper perspective on our finances, it's important to remember that God owns it all. We're simply stewards of a portion of the Lord's riches. When we have His point of view, we'll have the proper attitude toward our resources. For further study on being a wise manager of the things God has given you, visit intouch.org. There, you'll find many tools to help you get God's perspective on your finances. And that's where you can order a copy of today's complete message, The Grace of God and Our Finances. It's also included in our teaching set, Grace for Today. Again, that's intouch.org or call 1-800-INTOUCH. You can write to us at InTouch, P.O. Box 4900, Markham, Ontario, L3R6G9. When, would you say, are believers the most like Jesus? Keep listening for today's Moment with Charles Stanley.
From the Pastor's Heart is Dr. Charles Stanley's personal letter to you each month. You'll receive biblical insight and encouraging life lessons from Dr. Stanley. To receive From the Pastor's Heart, call 1-800-INTOUCH.
You hear the words, I forgive you. Your best friend suddenly rejects you. Emotions. From the ache of anxiety to the calm of contentment, Dr. Charles Stanley's series, How to Handle Your Emotions, can help you manage the way you respond to the events of your life. The set of 12 sermons, How to Handle Your Emotions, is $30 plus tax and shipping. To order, call toll-free. 1-800-INTOUCH. That's 1-800-468-6824.
Here's today's In Touch devotion.
Today's abridged scripture reading is from 1 Samuel chapter 17. Beginning in verse 20, we find the young shepherd, David, arriving at the Israelite army's encampment to deliver supplies to his brothers from their father. The Philistine army and a giant of a soldier named Goliath were taunting the Israelites. Verse 24. When all the men of Israel saw the man, they fled from him and were very fearful. And the men of Israel said, "Have you seen this man who is coming up? Surely he is coming up to defy Israel, and it will be that the king will make the man who kills him wealthy with great riches, and will give him his daughter, and make his father's house free in Israel." Then David said to the men who were standing by him, "What will be done for the man who kills this Philistine and rids Israel of the disgrace? For who is this uncircumcised Philistine that he has dared to defy the armies of the living God?" The people answered him in agreement with this statement, saying, "This is what will be done for the man who kills him." When the words that David spoke were heard, they informed King Saul, and he sent for him. And David said to Saul, "May no one's heart fail on account of him. Your servant will go and fight this Philistine." But Saul said,
"Living God." To him, a challenge to God's chosen nation of Israel was the same as defying the Lord himself. David was prepared to defend Yahweh's holy name and his people, even against this formidable warrior. It's possible for those of us who are believers to seek victory with wrong motives. In fact, many reasons that sound good are actually selfish. For example, "I'm tired of being in this mess." Or, "Lord, I can't run away, so you'll have to remove this problem." Or even, "If I had more money, then I'd give a tithe to my church." However, the right motive is a desire to follow, serve, and honor God. Life's Goliaths happen to us all, and our response to them will either impede or strengthen our walk with the Lord. As he did with David, God will give victory to those who stand strong in his name.
You can read today's devotion or hear it again on our website. Visit the devotion section at intouch.org. You can write to us at InTouch, P.O. Box 4900, Markham, Ontario, L3R6G9, or call 1-800-INTOUCH.
We are here live on our Sharathon, and it's so amazing, the things that have been going on. Thank you so much. Going out to North Bay, called in. I'll just read the last couple, just because I don't have time to read the whole list, but just the last few. North Bay called in with $25 a month. Thank you so much for becoming a partner with KFM. Another call from North Bay, $100 one time. A call from Sudbury, a $200 one-time gift, and a call from Timmins of a $1,000 gift. All of those add up, let me tell you, in this great Sharathon day of 20. We're so thrilled you're listening right now, and this is your chance to support Christian radio and keep hope alive. More people tuning in to KFM than ever before during these days, and some people really struggling. And we're just honored that we can deliver that message of hope. So many people called our feedback lines and said, "You have no idea what a lifeline KFM is to me and to my family." And other people calling in and saying, "I would just want you to know that my children go to bed every night listening to KFM because it puts Jesus in their hearts." Other people just COVID thing, and so thankful for Christian radio on the air. Your gift literally keeps hope alive in the lives of people all over Northern Ontario. So call in, give your best gift, whatever that might be. Become a monthly partner. Maybe you want to consider becoming one of that 1K Club partnership. Whatever you can do, we appreciate it. Here's the phone number. Call right now. It's 1-888-674-2585. 1-888-674-2585. We'll be back with you right after Focus on the Family.
Always a quick click on the internet. Deeks Insurance has been a licensed insurance brokerage since before Googling was a thing. So if you're looking to save on auto insurance that includes multi-vehicle discounts and first accident forgiveness or home coverage with enhanced water options, then start your search by typing Deeks Insurance. You'll already start saving on time spent searching the internet for the best insurance. Visit deeksinsurance.ca to get started with a quote. Deeks Insurance, where family matters.
But when you give your husband true compliments, it is like putting water on a plant. I know what I'm talking about. Do you all hear me? Even if they reject it, even if they act like it didn't move them, believe me, if you walk out the room and peek back at them, they like it.
On this edition of Focus on the Family, Patricia Ashley will share her remarkable testimony of how her marriage was saved, and she has some great ideas you can put into practice in your marriage today. I'm John Fuller, and your host is Focus President Jim Daly.
Man, I love the spark of life in her. Mm-hmm. John, I think all of us would admit, if we've been married for more than a few years, that no marriage is perfect. That's the reality, not one. And when that realization hits you, the critical question is, what do you do? Do you choose to lovingly confront your spouse and work through the issue, or do you ignore the problem and hope it'll go away? And if the problem continues, then what do you do? Today's speaker has the answers to those tough questions, and she's sharing with us out of her own pain from a marriage that was in terrible trouble. But Patricia Ashley and her husband Vernon ended up having a happy marriage, and they were married for over 45 years up until Vernon's death in 2018. Let's roll it, John.
Yeah, this is a great message. Lots of humor and insights and spark, as you said, Jim. Here now is Patricia Ashley speaking at a women's conference in Indian Wells, California, a number of years ago on today's episode of Focus on the Family.
My testimony is that when I got saved, I didn't know that God was going to save my marriage. I thought he was just going to save me. And God just, it was like my marriage being saved was a byproduct of me being saved. It wasn't as a result of anything that I did to develop my marriage or to work on my marriage. At the point where I was saved, I was sick of my relationship. And my husband was equally as sick of his relationship with me. Do you understand me? We mutually say that to people. You know, we were literally at the end. Our marriage was dead, waiting to be buried. Do y'all hear me? I mean, when I say it was dead, and some of you all are gonna relate to what I'm saying if you'll be honest. When I say it was dead, I mean that I didn't love my husband. I didn't hate him. I wasn't glad to see him come. I wasn't glad to see him go. It didn't make a difference what time he came in or if he came in at all. Yeah, do y'all, that's dead, huh? No feeling. He didn't make me happy. He didn't make me sad. He didn't even make me mad anymore. How many of you can relate to what I'm saying? Be honest. Come on, hallelujah. I know I'm telling the truth. That's where our relationship was. It was dead. And along with about 5 years of being unsaved in the military with no one to be accountable to, we were literally at the end, burnt out. And we just had one thing in common. We both dearly loved our two children. And that was what God used to hold us together. But after a while, that wasn't reason enough. Okay? And so I accepted Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior, and as a result, I began to read my word, not knowing what God was going to do with that. And my husband, he accepted Jesus in our dining room, and he began to read his word. And we were so, our lives were so isolated, we were so divorced emotionally, spiritually, and physically that he would read his Bible in one room, and I would read my Bible in another room. And as far as I was concerned, he had his Jesus, and I had mine. You understand what I'm saying? Now, were we at the end? I mean, we were, even after getting saved, I just, there was so, after so much hurt, after so much disappointment, after so much disillusionment, and that's where my marriage was. And as we grew in the Lord, and as we began to read the word, not even trying to be friends with each other again, not even trying to develop a relationship. We just started reading the word and loving the Lord. and allowing ourselves to learn who Jesus was, God allowed a situation to happen in one of our friends' lives. And we had to pray together. And when I found myself with my husband at the foot of our bed on our knees praying, we prayed. And as we began to cry out and pray together to the same God, little did we know that when we raised up our heads and we looked at each other, God had quickened our dead marriage. Do y'all hear what I'm saying? He had quickened it, and he had made it alive. And as a result of that, because we just both started growing in our relationship, God knitted our hearts back together. And now the love that we experience, it's different. Do you all hear what I'm saying? The commitment is different. And what we began to do is we began to go to the Word after we realized we liked each other again. That's where we started at. I just like you. Let's not deal with all this other stuff. And let's not try to get romantic or, you know, I just like you again. I respect you again. Come on now, you know how you can do that. You lose respect for them. They lose respect for you. They become bitter and indifferent and cold. And you become angry and hard and cold yourself. You know what I'm saying? And what we began to do was we began to invest time. When we saw that God had invested in our marriage, we made a commitment to invest into it. And then we went to the Word, and we began to look at what the Word of God had to say about marriage. Because you see, what we found out is all the way back over in Genesis, that marriage itself originated in the heart of God. It wasn't in the heart or the mind of man. God didn't just create man and woman and let them discover each other. He made them for each other. In the beginning, man, God said it's not good for man to be alone or woman to be alone. And what we must know as women of God is that everything that God has created and said was good. Now, if you... Those of you that are Bible students, think with me. Everything that God has created and said that was good, man, by the workings of hell, has perverted. Everything. It's not good for man to be alone. God gave him a wife. And how many women are being abused by the very men that are supposed to be nurturing and protecting them? How many men are rejecting the women? He said it's good that we bear children. How many abortions are being performed every day in this country alone? Everything that God said was good, and that was a gift. Not just good, but was a gift. God gave us physical intimacy, what the world calls sex. He said it's a gift. And look how perverted it is. It's so perverted that it's a bad word to say publicly. Everything that's good, and our marriages in the heart of God was good in his sight. The word says in Proverbs 18:22, it says that whosoever, and this is what God says, whosoever, meaning your husband, findeth a wife, meaning you, he has found a good thing. Hey, and have obtained favor of the Lord. So now, ladies, I want you to go back home and tell your husbands, precious, call him precious. Speak faith. Sweetheart, you have found a good thing in me. And because you have me, I don't care what you act like, but just because you have me, you have favor in God's sight. Hallelujah! Now that's what the Word say. You must say what the Word say. How many of you believe in saying what the Word say? That's what you got to say. Now you might not think he's worth it. Come on now, sometimes we don't. We don't think they deserve us as being good things. And some of us have been so beaten down and so criticized and so unappreciated that we don't feel like that's the heart of God. But God says, be healed today and get the mind of God. Think the thoughts of God. Know that regardless to how your husband just don't know, and you have to tell him. Now, what does that do to you? It puts you in a position where you've got to be a good thing. Meaning that his heart must be able to safely trust in you, that you'll do him no harm. If we just get the mind of God, now I know we got to get healed and we got to get a new attitude. But if we just say what the Bible says that when God looked at man, he saw that he needed a helper. And so we as females were created to be helpers. Come on now. Now I know in this new age movement where the God is within us, if we can believe it, we can achieve it. And you have to make sacrifices. So honey, sacrifice your marriage, sacrifice your children, and you have to achieve some of your goals in life, honey. Because when you sacrifice yourself and give your whole life to this man, and to your children, they will all up and leave you one day. That's the kind of foolish counsel that we get from the world and sometimes from sisters in the church. And so it's necessary for us, when we've been hurt, when we've been mistreated, when we've been misunderstood, unappreciated, all of that is real. We must take that to the very feet of Jesus and let him heal us. And we must allow God to strengthen us and to give us his attitude and to give us his wisdom as to how we are to handle the different situations in our lives.
This Focus on the Family broadcast will continue in just a moment.
Do you wake up and think of all the ways the day could go wrong? Does a list of worst-case scenarios play on a loop in your head? Can the littlest thing set off a spiral of what-ifs? Focus on the Family Canada has created a free PDF booklet filled with professional advice, biblical insights, and follow-up resource suggestions to help you better understand and navigate anxiety in your life. Download your free PDF booklet at focusonthefamily.ca/anxietypdf. That's focusonthefamily.ca/anxietypdf.
Financial Moments with Tom Copeland.
1 Corinthians 2, 14-15 says, "The man without the Spirit does not accept the things that come from the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness to him, and he cannot understand them, because they are spiritually discerned. The spiritual man makes judgment about all things. In my view, a godly financial advisor would be a spiritually mature Christian who understands and applies God's financial principles, has a close personal relationship with the Lord, has the necessary practical financial knowledge, and habitually puts the interest of clients first. With respect to finding a godly financial advisor, be careful, because unfortunately most Christians have limited knowledge of what the Bible says on finances, and as a result they give worldly financial advice, and they cannot teach you how to discern God's specific will. In summary, find a godly financial advisor to help you discern God's specific will before you make any major financial decision. To learn more, check out BibleFinance.org.
Thanks for listening to Focus on the Family. Let's resume now with the balance of today's programming.
For those of you that are married, you're going to give an account for how you were a wife to your husband. Doesn't matter how he acts. Do you understand what I'm saying? And the one thing I learned early when I started asking God to show me, he showed me, he said, number one, this man, you are not going to stand as a couple in my face to be judged for your works. You are not going to stand as a couple. You're going to stand as an individual and give an account. So now you can make a decision to unconditionally obey me as it relates to your responsibilities as a woman and as a wife. How's that? That's real tight, but it's right. Listen, I remember one day reading a book by this woman, and I believe the title was Me Obey Him. And it was a little book. And I think it was 99 pages. God couldn't send anyone to me to tell me or teach me the principles of submission. I was that strong-willed and that self-willed and that determined. So God allowed me to pick up this little book, and this little book is a hammer, okay? When I read the book, I fell on my face when I got through with the last page, and I cried out. I said, oh, God, you don't know him. Come on now. I said, listen, if I do what this woman said, he gonna have me doing all kind of crazy things. But God took me back, and he said, listen, I wrote this book. And what she's sharing from her book is as a result of what she got from this book. And heaven and earth will pass away, but I will not change my mind. And God really brought me to a point. He said, it's not an issue of your submitting to him. It's an issue of your submitting to me. He said, because when you can submit to me, you won't fear submitting to him. Do you all hear me? And he said, when you submit to me, I can change his heart. Come on now. He said, now certainly if I could clamp the mouths of the lions, he said, if I could do that, and he said, if I could open up the Red Sea and let the children of Israel cross on dry land, who is this little man? Who is he? Come on now. Now, ladies, look, I don't want to paint an ugly picture of my husband because he is so precious, but he's a man. Do you all hear what I'm saying? And being in the military, he's a military man. And they believe in order and structure. And I told him God gave me to him to balance his life out. Hallelujah. But listen, when God dealt with me, I watched God change his heart. And God began to soften him up. And do you know when God began to show me, and that's what we need to do. We need to talk to ourselves. We need to say, self, shut up. Self, sit down. Listen, you get you a friend, get you a sister to be accountable to, a prayer partner that it would like to invest in your marriage. I believe that we should choose people that's committed to our husbands. If your girlfriend will sit and help you criticize your husband, get rid of her or stop her. Stop her, I'm serious, stop her. And I think we should understand each other. We should let each other bleed. You know what I'm saying? In a safe environment. But don't bleed on a woman if she is not committed to the success of your marriage. Come on now. Don't bleed on her because she's going to do one or the other. She's going to put your marriage asunder or take your husband. She'll do one or the other. I know I'm telling the truth. If she lets you continue to criticize your husband, you know, and I would sit and listen to women, and I do it now because you know what? We need to do that. I think that's why so many marriages are falling apart now. It's because women don't have those circles that they can move in, we're so busy with our job. We go from work to home. We have to cook. We have to take care of the kids, get ready for the next day. Some of you all commute 20 and 30 miles and some probably more. And you don't really have the energy and the kind of time that God requires of you to invest into your marriage. And so the first pressure or the first trauma that your marriage experiences, it starts to fall apart because you don't have that network. You don't have that support group. But God would have us to network in a safe, godly environment where you can leave here feeling I'm committed to the success of my own marriage first. And then begin to ask God to give you someone that's committed to the success of your marriage. They will encourage you. And you'll know that they'll be disappointed if you don't stand firm and do all to stand. That's having someone in your life that's committed to the success of your marriage. Praise God. You can't be married by yourself. You need someone to help encourage you. And that's what the older ladies used to do. I remember my mother telling me when my husband first left to go to the military, I didn't want to leave Alabama and follow him. And my mother said to me, honey, you better go with your husband. You better go with your husband. Stay there, work it out. Now listen, my mother gave me this counsel. I didn't think it was so wise, but I didn't understand what it meant at the time. I later learned. She said, now listen. She said, when your bed get hard, just roll over. Yeah. I said, what? Come on. I said, she need to break this down and interpret this. I don't understand what that meant. But what she meant was, look, when it get tight, when things don't go right, you be committed. You stay in there. And you work it out. And for those of us that are born again, pray through. Pray through. But be committed to it. Listen, it says that we're to leave and cleave. The word says that in Genesis 2:24, that for this reason, you will never be fulfilled in your marriage if you don't leave and cleave. Some of us still have emotional ties. We still have soul ties with mom and dad. Come on now. We do. Now, my husband was the youngest child that his mother had. She called him her million-dollar gold piece. Now, can you imagine what position that put me in? I could top that if I wanted to. And that was the way she treated him. Like he was her million. And she let me know when we were dating, that's what she called it. And a large amount of our struggle in our relationship was because there was a soul tie between he and his mother. And that thing had to be broken, but it wasn't until we got in the Word that we realized that I was now his wife and his mother was his daddy's wife. Hallelujah. Come on now. And so what we had to do, that we had been married and saved a long time before we realized this. What we had to do is on one of our trips back home, he had to go to his mother. And he had to say, he had to go to his father first and ask his father to forgive him for having a place in his mother's heart that only he should have had. Now, I'm not talking about sensuous or anything like that. I ain't talking about being perverted. Y'all understand what I'm talking about. Okay. But he had to go to his mother and say, I want to ask you to forgive me for taking that place and requiring that. He said, and I want to release you now back to your husband. And I want to be your son, one that would honor you. But you, I release you back to your husband. And he had to do this in front of me and his dad. And his daddy was a glad brother. Give me my wife. Come on now. But do you know what healing took place between he and his father? And that was how that was broken. And God began to use my husband to minister to his mother and use his mother to minister to him. It got godly.
On that note, we're going to have to step in here and wrap up this part of a great presentation from Patricia Ashley on today's episode of Focus on the Family. Jim, she has been so honest about the struggles in her marriage and the hope she found in doing things the way God recommends. We're going to hear more from Patricia next time.
Isn't it amazing that when we as individuals start to seek God wholeheartedly, we see benefits, not just in our spirit, but in our relationships, our work, and even our health. And I just love the fact that Patricia Ashley didn't demand that God rescue her marriage. She just began seeking the Lord with her whole heart. And then her husband got saved, their marriage got saved, and even her husband's relationship with his parents improved. That's what we talk about in terms of the Christian life. When you live it out, the benefits are there.
Well, that is really true, and I hope Patricia's story has motivated you as a listener to take that first step toward making things right with your spouse, and just watch and see how God can work in your marriage.
Well, you know what? Someone has to take that first step. That's the hardest part. We can talk all day long, but if your heart doesn't open up and you don't reach out to your spouse, nothing is going to change. Let me just say, if you are in an abusive situation, it's important that you get to a place of safety for yourself and your children, but keep praying for your spouse and for their healing. You know, strong marriages make for healthy families where children can grow up in a safe and loving atmosphere. Here at Focus on the Family, we want to do everything we can to help couples improve their relationship, like Patricia Ashley talked about today. And boy, this past year has been very tough on marriages. Our counseling team is seeing that in the calls we receive here every day. So let me remind you that we are here for you. Call us if you need help. And if you feel that your marriage is in real dire straits, ask about our Hope Restored Intensives, which have an over 80% success rate 2 years later as we survey them.
Yeah, just call 800, the letter A and the word family to set up that consultation or seek additional help. Again, that number, 800-232-6459.
And let me encourage you to make a donation to help support all of our efforts to help marriages across Canada thrive. And when you get in touch, ask about how to get a CD copy of this message from Patricia Ashley. It also has extra content.
Yeah, it's a great resource to pass along to a friend or just to enjoy again with that additional content. Request your copy when you call 800-A-FAMILY, 800-232-6459, or donate online and request that CD at focusonthefamily.ca. Then next time, be sure to join us as Patricia explains why it's important to decide that God is able to improve your marriage.
You get out of your husband's face, and you get in the face of God. You stop talking and pulling on your husband, and you begin to talk and pull on God.
On behalf of Jim Daly and the entire team, thanks for joining us today for Focus on the Family. I'm John Fuller, inviting you back as we once more help you and your family thrive in Christ.
Well, here we go. It is time for Sharathon 2021. We got a couple of minutes here to get in and tell you, first of all, Curtis, we got a winner. We've got a winner of the Mastercraft tool set.
Winner, winner. Congratulations going out to Bill Van Ship. You have won
this Bill, hour's giveaway. Awesome. Bill, congratulations.
Oh, yeah.
Of course, we continue. We continue this half hour with the Indigo gift card available up for grabs. $50 value. Buy some brand new books from the Indigo gift card stores available. And that's our prize this half hour. Curtis, how do people get in on this?
You can call right now. We have some amazingly wonderful people standing by on the telephones. Their number is 1-888-674-2585. Toll free from anywhere.